Hi friends, this is a problem on speed time curve. So let us see speed time curve and schedule speed. Let us see what he has asked and try to solve this problem. So he has given a train has schedule speed of 30 km/h. So schedule speed has been given, that is 30 km/h over a level track, and the distance between stations being 1 km, so distance has been given, and station stopping time is 20 seconds, so stopping time has been given, it is 20 seconds. Assuming braking retardation of 3 km/h, so beta has been given, it is 3 km/h, and the maximum speed is 25% greater than the average speed, so Vm has been given as 25% greater, that means 1.25 of average speed Va. Calculate the acceleration required to run the service. So we need to calculate the acceleration. This is the problem. So let us first recollect the formula for schedule speed. So the formula is schedule speed is equal to distance between the stops divided by actual time plus stopping time. So if you substitute all the values here, the scheduled speed is 30 km/h, so it will be 30 is equal to, the distance is 1 km, and actual time, we don't know the actual time, so actual time plus stopping time, so the stopping time is 20 seconds. As 20 is in second, so we need to convert this 30 km/h into 30 km/h into kilometer per second, so it should be divided by 3600. Therefore actual time plus 20 is equal to 3600 divided by 30, this will be 120, which is equal to 120, and it has been given that the stopping time is 20 seconds, so therefore the actual time will be, which is equal to 120 minus 20, so which is equal to 100 seconds. So this is the actual time. Now let us calculate average speed. As average speed has been, the maximum speed has been given in terms of average speed, so let me concentrate on average speed VA. VA is equal to distance divided by actual time of run. So the distance is 1 kilometer divided by actual time of run is 100 second. And I want to convert VA into, I want VA into km/h. So I need to convert into, multiply with 3600, because this here it is second, so it should be converted into hour. So these two should be cancelled, and this will be 36 km/h. Therefore Vm is equal to, according to his data, 1.25 into Va, which is equal to, it's 1.25 into 36, which is 45 km/h. Now we need to calculate for beta. One formula is available for us in speed time curve, which is 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta is equal to 7200 capital D divided by Vm square into Vm by V average minus 1, which implies 1 by alpha, I don't know this part and I want to calculate that, 1 by where beta is 3 km/h, which is equal to 7200 into 1 kilometer divided by Vm square is 45 into 45 into 1.25 minus 1. Okay, let's calculate here. It's 1 by alpha, I want this part, divided by 1 by beta is 3, which is equal to 7200 divided by Vm square. So 45 into 45 into Vm is 1.25 times Va minus 1. Okay, so it is 1.25 times Va divided by Va. So Va will get cancelled and it will be like this. And finally, which is equal to 9800 times and 5 1 time, and it will be 160, and which is equal to 160 divided by 45 into 1 by 4. It is 1.25 minus 1 is 0.25, so it will be 1 by 4. 4 will go in 40 times, and this is 580 and 590, which is equal to 8 by 9. So it is 8 by 9, which implies 1 by alpha is equal to 8 by 9 minus 1 by 3, which is equal to, the LCM is 9, 8 minus 3, which is 5 by 9. Therefore, alpha is equal to 9 by 5, which is equal to 1.8 kmph. So this is the final answer for this problem. Thank you one and all. If you like this video, please like it. If you have any doubts, please comment in my comment box, and please share this video and kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Hi friends, this is the second problem in speed time curve. Let us see what he has asked and how to solve this problem. A train runs with an average speed of 40 kmph, and average speed has been given here, and distance between the station is 2 km. So average speed is equal to 40 kmph, and the distance has been given as 2 km, and values of acceleration and retardation are 1.5 kmph, and beta is 2.5 kmph. Find the maximum speed of the train assuming trapezoidal speed time curve. So I need to find Vm. So it has given us, it is trapezoidal speed time curve. So let me take the formula directly, and after that we will see what we need to do. Vm is, the direct formula is capital T minus square root of T square minus 14,400 kd divided by 2k. This is the formula. So let us see what we know. So capital T is the time. So here we need to find the time first. Actually, we know the speed. So average speed is equal to distance traveled divided by actual time, which is equal to distance traveled is 2 km divided by, which implies we want actual time. So actual time is equal to distance divided by average speed. Distance is 2 km divided by average speed is 40 kmph. So it is in 40 kmph. So we need to convert it into seconds into 3600 will go get cancelled, and 4 means it's 90, which is equal to 180 second. This is time t, which is equal to t 180, and after that I need to calculate k. Now I want to calculate k, where capital k is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta, which is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by 1.5 plus 1 by 2.5, which is equal to 1 by 1.5 is 10 by 15 and 1 by 2.5 is 10 by 25. If I take 10 as common, it will be 1 by 15 plus 1 by 25, which is equal to, let me take this off, it is 5. So 5 into, the LCM will be 75 go with 15 5 times, so it will be 5 plus 75 goes with 70 25 in 3 times, so it will be like this, and 5 will go in 75 in 15 times, so it will be 8 by 15. This is the value. If you substitute all the values here, it is 180 minus square root of 180 square minus 14,000, this much divided by 8 by 15 into 2 whole divided by 2k, 2 into 8 by 15. If you calculate the thing, you will get 46.5 kmph. Okay, this is very simple problem. It's a direct question from trapezoidal speed time curve. Okay, this small extra thing will be only the, we need to calculate actual time and k, that's all. That means if this is, if you feel that this is the direct formula, so whatever we require we need to calculate. We want only time and k, d already given, so we need to calculate them and we need to finish the problem. If you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video, please share with your friends and family, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you. Thank you very much.